Hey guys, I'm happy to share with you my first tutorial on Unreal Engine 5, and today we're going to talk about camera shaking. Camera shaking in Unreal Engine 5 is really simple and straightforward. All you have to do is to create a blueprint. I just open up a quick scene from a first person template, and what we're going to do is just get a new blueprint class, right click blueprint class, and I'm gonna look after all classes and just type camera shake, and we're gonna select default camera shake base and select it. Okay, name BP shake 001. That's it. Yes, you just have to create a blueprint, and now we just get to play around with some settings and just put it in your sequencer. Once we created the blueprints, when you open up, you have the graph, the classic event graph, and all settings are on the right panel. You can just go from there and tweak all the little parameters here. But what I advise you is just to close it and open it again. I don't know why, but now you have a quick settings system UI, much easier to look around and easier to set up. So this is basic settings of the camera shake in Unreal. You have the blurring noise and composite, sequence and wave oscillator. Most common is blurring and wave oscillator. Once you have the blueprints, the easiest way is to put it directly in the level sequencer. So I just created a quick sequence with the camera. So I select my camera, I just hit play. You see just quick movements, just in order to show you how it's working. So it's linear, it's simple. I just have to add now the camera shake. And how to do it? It's simple. You just go to your components here, so your camera components, and you click on the press track and you add the camera shake. And here you will see the blueprint you just created earlier. If you didn't create anything, nothing will appear. So now you select it. It seems that nothing happened, but you just have to open the tab, and here is our blueprint shake. So if I press play, now seems like nothing happened, it's normal. You just have to tweak now parameters. So if I go to my content drawer and open up my blueprint shake, we have all these parameters. And the first one that it's important is duration. By default, it's set to 1, but if you put it 10, immediately you see in the sequencer that it's gonna go almost all the way to my sequence. And after you have the blend in and the blend out, just the intro, outro. So if I want to have a smoother transition from the beginning and the end, I just can play with these two sliders. So like if I put it to 5, you will see it's a long curve, smoother than before. And after, we just have to play with location, rotation, and field of view. So it's really simple. Location is just all the translation movements. So from right to left, up and down, forward, backward. Rotation, it's all roll, tilt, pitch. And you have the field of view, it's like a quick zoom. So from there you have specific parameters. So from axis X, Y, Z, same for rotation, but with pitch, yaw, roll, and the same for field of view, but just with two parameters. So for example, if I put like a 10 in amplitude and compile and save, and if I press play, you see you have a subtle movement of camera shaking. And what we're gonna do is gonna crank up a little bit our duration here in timing. So if nothing happened, just like this, it's because you have to extend your camera shake. I have everything set up for the whole sequencer, and we're gonna play it with some settings. So I put an amplitude of 10, and I'm gonna put a frequency of 5, and this is what we get. So now I'm gonna show you one of my scene where I use multiple camera shakes, and just in order to show you how it is. So here we have a scene I made with a rat running through a quick little scene. And just to show you what we get with camera shaking in Unreal Engine, I wanted to make like a quick run, a panic run, 3 camera shake using blueprints, that I have this result. And if we go in our sequencer, you can see that I use, so as I said, 3 camera shake, and I just put some different settings in order to have a global one, a breath, and at the end, like a panic one. And if I go to my content drawer, here I have my 3 camera shake using blueprints, and I go to my, like, the panic one, the last one, I just play with some different axes in the location and rotation and the field of view. And after, I just put it in the end and just play it through. I will let you play around with this because you can go really, really in multiple ways of what you want at the final. So here for you guys, the settings I use for this scene. So for a global camera shake, a breath one, and a panic one. Feel free to use it, copy and analyze it. So this is it guys, hope it will help you in your creation and your camera animation in Unreal Engine 5. So if you liked it, please leave a like, subscribe to my channel and leave a comment. It helps me a lot and see you for some next tutorial. Bye!